All right, guys, so in this video, we'll be looking at different campaign objectives. Okay, now your objective is just like your goal, what you want to achieve with your campaigns on Facebook, with your ads on Facebook. And there are different objectives that have been populated on Facebook that you can make use of. So we have a couple of them right here. And the first one that you see here is brand awareness. Now, if you look at this column, you can see they have awareness up here. So this is like the top of funnel. Okay, so you don't really are interested in getting any form of sales. Okay, you're not interested in getting people to take any certain action. All right, you just want people to know about your brand. Okay, you're just interested in people knowing about your brand. This is what telecommunication companies do in order to create awareness. Okay, so they want people to know about them, they want people to always hear about their name. Okay, so that's brand awareness. You don't desire people taking action, you don't desire them purchasing anything. Of course, in the process, they might decide to purchase something, but your goal, your objective is not for them, it's not for people to make purchases or take any action, but for them to learn about you, for them to know about your business. That is what brand awareness is for. Now, reach is just like brand awareness, okay, because of course you are not interested in any other thing other than actually reaching more people. So these objectives allow you to reach a wide range of people. All right, so if you are running something like reach campaigns, it has to be a form of retargeting campaigns. All right, so that's for that. Now the next one that we see here is traffic. Okay, so when you run traffic ad, now if I hover on this I button, it just simply says send more people to a destination on or off Facebook, such as website, app, or messenger conversation. All right, so right here, what you basically just want to do is drive traffic, drive people to your website, drive people to your Facebook page, drive people to your Facebook Messenger for conversations. Okay, you are not necessarily looking for them to do anything, you are not looking for them to fill a form or to purchase something, you just want them to go to your website and see what is there. In the process, they might, some people will decide to buy. All right, some of course will not decide to buy, majority of them are not going to buy. Traffic objective allows Facebook to look at people who always click to visit websites. Okay, so when you click on when you use the traffic objective, it necessarily don't mean Facebook is going to target people who are going to purchase from your website. Rather, Facebook is just going to target people whose action has shown that they are always clicking to a website. They are always clicking to visit website. They are always clicking to look at something. Okay, so those are the kind of people that Facebook will target. Okay, yeah, amongst this group of persons, there's some who will take action such as purchasing from your website. But on a wider range, Facebook is targeting people who have shown over time, okay, that they like clicking on links, okay, not necessarily that they like buying. So Facebook is going to show your ads to more people who actually click links. I hope you get that. Now the second one, we are on the third one. The fourth one we see here is called engagement objective. Okay, now engagement objective simply means you want interaction with your campaigns. Okay, you want people to interact with your campaigns. Engagement simply means people are viewing your videos that you have on Facebook. People are reading your posts. People are liking it. People are commenting on it. That is engagement. People are engaging with your post. Now, this doesn't mean that in the process of people doing this, you are not going to see results such as purchase or sales on your website. Of course, some people will take such actions, but the primary objectives for this is for people to engage with your ad. Okay, so Facebook is going to show your ad to people who have shown over time that they are good with engagement. They are always commenting on posts, they are always liking posts on Facebook, they are always viewing videos. Those are the kind of people that Facebook is going to look out for in your chosen audience. Okay, whatever your objective is, Facebook is going to carry it out in your chosen audience. All right, so for instance, if you're targeting people in the beauty interest or in a beauty niche, so your interest is beauty and your objective is engagement, Facebook is going to show your ad to people who are likely to engage with your post. They like, they comment, but they are within the beauty category that you have chosen to reach. I hope that makes some sense. All right, now the fifth one here is app installs. This is very straightforward. This is just to get more people to install your app. If you have an app, this is what you do. Now, video views is also an engagement form of ad, but they just put it aside for clarifications and all that. Okay, so you can decide to just say video views, and it's also an engagement ad, so you get more people to view your video content. All right, so lead generation is like an action kind of objective. So you want people to fill a form. Okay, you want them to take an action, you want them to do something, you want them to fill a form so you can get their contact details, their emails and their names. All right, now messages are same thing as conversion kind of people who want, you want people to take action. Okay, you want people to be able to send you messages, whether on your messenger or maybe on your WhatsApp. You know, those are considered message campaigns. So Facebook is likely to show your campaigns to people who over time have shown that they are likely to click and send you a message either on Facebook or on WhatsApp. Okay, now the other one we have here is conversion campaigns. Conversion campaigns means you want a certain action from people. You want them to take action. You don't just want them to go to your website and just look at what you have. You want people who are more likely to take action. You want people who are more likely to purchase. You want people who are more likely to add to cart. You know, you want people who are more likely to view your pages. That is what conversion ad is. Okay, so Facebook, when you choose a conversion ad, depending on the action that you want them to perform on your site, Facebook is going to tailor your ad and direct your ad to such people. Okay, now we have the catalog sales. All right, so this is for people who have different products. Okay, you have different products, so you can have them arranged in the form of catalog, so people on Facebook can scroll and then see the different products that you have. This is a form of campaign that people like Jumia run. Okay, so if you have a big e-commerce website, catalog sales is a form of objective that you look into. Is it considered a form of conversion form of campaign because you want people to go to your website and make sales? So Facebook is going to show your ads to such people. Now the other one here is store traffic. Okay, so store traffic is basically just driving people to your store. All right, you want more people to visit your store. That's what store traffic is. So Facebook is just going to show your ad to people who visit your store. Okay, so that's what Facebook is going to do. It's just going to show your ad to such people who are to visit your store, and not necessarily they're going to buy, but just driving people to your store. They make sure they are going to drive lots of traffic to your store. So now, putting all of this together, for you who is into e-commerce, what are the type of campaigns that you should pay more attention to. All right. Now, there are certain campaigns that you pay attention to, like the conversion campaigns. You can do traffic engagement, video views, all right, messages. Okay, so we're going to look at these objectives. Okay, so for instance, if you decide to choose the traffic objective, remember I said traffic objective means you want to send people to a page on Facebook or outside of Facebook. You don't just want to send people to just seek something, right? Not necessarily take an action. Okay, so from here you can see website. So you need a website to run such a campaign. Okay, so if you are running traffic objective, you, for instance, and your interest, your target interest is beauty. Okay, I'm not saying you should use beauty, I'm just illustrating, I'm just showing you something. So when you have something like this, what Facebook is going to do is show people who are likely visit, who click on links and visit a page. Okay, that is what Facebook is going to do. So it's going to show such people in this audience. Okay, people in this audience who have shown that they click on links and visit websites. So Facebook is going to do that and show your ads to them. So you have the opportunity to show your ads to a lots of people. Out of those people, of course, you are going to have conversions such as sales, but you are going to spend more. Okay, that's how you are going to spend more to reach those specific people who are going to take action. Okay, not that you are not going to see results from it, you are going to see results, but it's, you have to be more patient, because Facebook, we had tried to test different people to see what exactly is going on around your audience. Okay, so when you choose something like traffic, Facebook is just going to show your campaigns, your ads to people who visit website. This is very important to understand. When you choose traffic, Facebook is going to show your ad to people who visit website. Not necessarily that people will not buy. People will buy, but you are going to have lots of traffic. So you can see 1,000 traffic and then not even a sale. Okay, if you run traffic kind of campaigns, it should be for gathering data. Okay, so most of the time when I run traffic campaigns, it's for me to gather data. I'm not necessarily looking for sale, but I want to see the number of people who go to my page, and people who go land on different pages. From there, I can create conversion ads. Okay, it becomes easy for Facebook to run your conversion campaigns when they have data to work with. So from here, you can choose what you want. You want Messenger, or you want people to go to your WhatsApp. So Facebook is going to show your ads to people who are likely to click to your WhatsApp. Okay, so people who are likely to interact more on WhatsApp, Facebook is going to show your ads to such people. So when you select something like this, you choose your page. Okay, you choose your page, and then you connect your WhatsApp business account if you haven't done that. Is that easy to do? All right, the other campaign I want us to look at is conversion campaign. All right, now for engagement, video views, those ones, they have explained. Okay, Facebook is going to show your ads to people who engage with your ads. Okay, that's what Facebook is going to do. People who engage, people who comment a lot. I'm not saying that Facebook is not good, you're not going to get rid, not that you're not going to get results such as sales from it, but primarily the objective of your campaign is for Facebook to show your ads to people who comment a lot on ads. Okay, now let's look at conversion campaigns. Now, conversion campaigns, I've explained that you are interested in people taking action on your site. So for such campaigns, you need more patience. Okay, so you can even run a campaign like this, and it is gone for 24 hours, and you can see that the reach is just 500. Okay, because Facebook is trying to look for people who will perform the action that you have chosen. So let's choose this now and click continue for us to see the different. Okay, so now these are the different events. Okay, these are the different events. Okay, you can see them right here. The different events or action that you want people to perform on your site. Okay, so you want them to view content, that's an action. You want them to search. You want them to add to cart, you want them to add to wish list, you want them to add payment info or purchase or lead or registration or contact. So depending on what you choose, so for instance, you choose purchase, Facebook, what Facebook does is it's going to show your ad to people more likely to click on that button that says shop now. I believe you've seen lots of ads on Facebook with the button shop now. So what Facebook is going to do is show your ads to such people who always click on shop now. Okay, so you have a higher percentage of people who will buy, but it takes time to convert. Okay, so for such, for a campaign like this, you need to put in some good money to, you know, for it to start optimizing, but the optimization is slow. Okay, it's slow for you to start seeing those massive results. It's very quick for you to see results with traffic ads. So because of course it's traffic ad, anyone can click on an ad and go to a website, right? Anyone can quickly see an ad and like the ad because the picture looks beautiful, right? Anyone can see a video and watch it because it's interesting, but you know, that's just curiosity, right? So it's easy for you to see massive results. So you see you getting 1,000 clicks or with traffic ads or 1,000 likes on your ads and then no one is purchasing. This is the reason, okay? When you choose such campaign objective, Facebook is going to focus on such people. It's going to get such people to see your ads. So if you choose a conversion campaign, it's going to take a while. It's going to take a while. But even though this is the best campaign to run, conversion ads are the best campaigns to run, it's not wrong for you to have traffic campaigns and video views campaign. Because why? It helps Facebook to learn about your audience. You know, over time, I tell people that Facebook work with data. The more data Facebook has, the more it's able to learn about your audience and the more results it's going to give to you. All right. So you can even have those campaigns running simultaneously. So you have a campaign on traffic, you have a campaign on video views, you have a campaign of conversion. All right. So it helps Facebook to learn about your audience and what exactly you want. Over time, you run all these for 3 days and you see which is actually giving you more results, and then you optimize, you optimize your ads, you see what is working for you and what is not working for you. So that is it, guys. That is all I actually want to show you about this campaign objectives. Okay, so what is going through your mind right now is, Jonathan, which campaign objective should I use, right? I know that's what you're asking now. Now, for me, I use conversion objective a lot. I use it a lot. But what I do is I run it simultaneously with other objective. I run it simultaneously with traffic objective and video views. Okay, these are the three objectives that I run and test and scale from there and optimize from there. So if you're asking me, that is what I would say. Use conversion of campaigns. Okay, choose the conversion objective. Use traffic objective as well. Okay, but don't say you're not seeing results from traffic objective. That is just for you to gather data. Okay, and don't say that your ad has been running, you are running a conversion campaign and you say your ad has been running for 24 hours now, but you only reached a 1,000 persons. That is how conversion ads work. It is slow to pick up because Facebook is now more specific. They are not looking at a pool of people who would likely perform your kind of action, okay, than it is to find people who will likely click or comment or like a post. It's to see someone who will like a post, comment on a post, is easier compared to someone who is going to purchase. All right. So I believe you understand all of this, and this helps you to choose the right objective for your Facebook campaigns.